Hello everyone, welcome to Vet Basics. Today we will see about application of splint with fiberglass material. What is fiberglass? Fiberglass is nothing but a synthetic plastic that can be shaped. This material can be applied as a cast or splint. Cast and splints are used to immobilize the orthopedic injury. They promote healing, maintain the bone alignment and reduce the pain and protect the injury site. So when to use cast and when to use splint? The cast gives more support and protection to the injured part than splint. In case of acute injury, when the body part is swollen, we should apply splint. So we can tighten or loosen easily if the swelling in body part increased or decreased. Comparatively, the splints are very easy to apply than the cast. And also to remove, we don't need any special instruments, but in case of cast, we need some instrument to cut open. So now we will apply a splint to immobilize a joint in a fold. Now I want to immobilize pastern joint in this fold, so just I am measuring the length to prepare splint. We have measured the length, so I am cutting. Just it was moistened little bit. And you know, layer by layer we have to apply. For splint application, we can use bamboo sticks or PVC pipe or plaster of Paris. I will tell why did I choose this fiberglass material. This fiberglass material is very lighter, more durable and more water resistant and more easily penetrated by x-rays. The thickness of the splint is based on body weight and the place where we put. After the arrangement of layers, we have to mold this splint according to shape or conformation of the part or limb. We cannot use the splint as it is because the fetlock is not straight. There we have angle. So we have to mold the splint according to the angle. If I choose any PVC pipe, even if we paint also, it may break within 1 or 2 days. And plaster of Paris also will not bear the weight. So that is also easily breakable. I am just cutting the sharp edges around the splint because the sharp edges are very dangerous. Allow the splint to dry and get hardened. I am applying the adhesive plaster in the edges so we can avoid the injuries caused by the sharp edges. Okay, now the splint is ready. We will apply. This is boric acid, basically an antiseptic. Here, this will produce heat, so the moisture will be lost. The legs become dry. The padding is very important for the splint application. So we have to apply good cotton. Now I am applying the bandage roll because the cotton will slip away. So to avoid that, just I applied bandage roll. So next, the application of cotton. So we have to apply the cotton evenly. So the pressure also will be even. The cotton should be placed a little above and below the splint edges because the edges are more dangerous. So to avoid the injuries, we should apply more cotton in both edges. Placing the splint at the correct level is very important. The foal or the animal should bear the weight in the splint. so it should be placed at hoof level. Now you apply the adhesive plaster. Apply the plaster above and below the bent area. Start at the splint so you will have grip to tighten it. You have to tighten the plaster in a way that it is not very loose or it's not very tight. In both cases, it is dangerous. Just for extra support, applying the grip bandage. Animal will not cooperate in most of the orthopedic cases because of the pain. So it is better to sedate or even anesthetize the animal for a better job. The ability to apply splint or cast is a technical skill easily mastered with the practice and an understanding the basics of principle. I hope this splint will help to maintain the normal conformation or the anatomy of the limb. Please like and share if you feel the video is useful, and subscribe my channel for the upcoming videos. Thanks for watching.